kids die. When the rides I walk by, broken hearted as I glance at the truck line, getting high. This ain't the life for me, I wanna change, but ain't no future right for me. I'm stuck in the game, I'm trapped inside a maze. See this tangerine influence, me, they're getting crazy, disillusioned lately. I've been really wanting babies, so I can see a part of me that wasn't always safe. Don't trust my lady, she's a rock, there's poison, I'm hearing noises. Think she's talking on my boys, can't take the war. I'm falling to the floor, begging for the Lord to let me into heaven's door. Shed so many tears.
Wake up and come to know there is no He-Man, X-Man, Superman, Batman. There is no Captain Marvel, Captain America. You live in a fantasy world, a world which takes a Caucasian image and puts it out there as if it should be the super god of existence. In reality to the universe, it is like a tiny white virus floating around in a gigantic ocean of blackberry juice. The universe is 99.9% black. I mean, one can play that game here on a planet that is engulfed in negative energy as a result of the reptilians locking everyone down and maintaining this matrix. However, outside of that illusion, there is a massive reality which is currently bombing the underground bases of the United States. Just recently, on August the 22nd, the Galactic Federation bombed the entrances to the CIA's facility underground, which is intercontinental, I believe they said, stretching all the way across from Culpeper, Virginia, to Trinidad, Alabama. That must have put a devastating hurt on the powers that be. Because you want to play in the adult arena, the Galactic Federation is ready and eager for you to jump and make your move in this adult arena. Whoa! But behold to him. The scam, the Romans, the Anunnaki, and the Zionists fabricated was to pretend that this albino creature here was the Christ being who was born in Africa as a cosmic scientist. Instead, they give you the fabricated religion which they made up for the purpose of controlling the minds of the humans on planet Earth. The universe is a wonderful university because it provides lessons for the students via the experiential process. So we see here the insanity of the Caucasian species manufactured by the reptilians in wanting to see its image as that of some non-existing god. Notice that these attitudes and these gestures illustrate that the Zionists who fabricated this belief system has absolutely no knowledge whatsoever about the creation. Prime creator subdivides itself to produce the Melchizedek order, subdivides the Melchizedek order to produce the Christ order. These are orders of beings, thousands of levels and zillions of beings in these orders. Then comes the God as the supreme being ordered. You will never hear a Christ talking about God the Father, my Father, because the supreme being God personality, which is the Father of the universes, comes out of the Christ order. So these dumb knuckleheads got it all ass backwards because they are absolutely ignorant to the creation. They come out of abject darkness. The reptilians operate in abject darkness with no consciousness other than the lower level of the fourth dimension, which is the hellish realm, the same realm that the Zionist comes out of. Neither one of them have any light and consciousness whatsoever and have never produced an ascended master, let alone a Christ being, because they do not have a clue. Their objective is making slaves and perpetuating wars where they can murder humans on a massive scale, which is their love and their desire through such trickery and deceit as one sees here and one sees each and every day in these Western nations, particularly with the black blondes of today, believing that this inferior recessive gene image is the superior image being promoted by the image makers of Hollywood as well as the advertising agencies here in white racist America. The Andromedans relate to Alex Collier that angels are fleets of spaceships and that archangels are fleets of motherships. These are merely code names for the members of the Galactic Federation who are here stationed in our solar system for the purpose of preventing the reptilian Leviron Federation forces from taking over planet Earth. The ignorant whites who have produced these religions with this suffering Jesus Christ figure took the information that the Zionists manufactured through the Roman family of Arius Calpurnius Piso and gave the world a fairy tale belief system and a fairy tale concept. Christ has nothing to do with these ignorant images of some suffering man here to save the humans from their sins. Lucifer sent four Christs in here as a military strategy, and the reptilians snatched up their purpose for being here and transferred it into some nonsensical religious garbage which has nothing to do with anything real. Christ, his wife, his daughter Sarah, the ascended masters out of the Africa, and the Christ beings the Africans produced in the pyramid schools of Egypt, completed charging those countless millions of grids, which they took some 11,000 years placing around our planets astral plane.
So there you have it. You're not going to be able to sit around now and act like nobody didn't tell you the truth. So when it go down, you ain't going to be able to sit up and try to blame any other devastating weather formations or any other outcomes of your sorrow on anyone else but yourself. I came a long way to point all this stuff out to people, and I know I've done a good job of it. So I'm not going to be held responsible for the people who's going to be suffering from the cognitive dissonance that I'm sure all of you suffer from. So you're on your own with that. Mayotte Hotel, this is Brother Ashwa Kwesi. Now I got this off YouTube, so I'm going to go ahead and run it. This brother right here is really, really deep. He's got some really good information. He is one of the pioneers that got me started. I saw him at one of my friends' Sunshine House. I was in Los Angeles. I was on my way to West Angeles Church. I ran into this brother. He told the white boy, "You need to get you a white woman. Stay away from our black women." I was on the bus. I heard him say that. I got off the bus and went and started talking to him. I said, "Man, don't you think you was wrong for doing that? I mean, don't people have a right to be who they want?" I was impressed that he did it, but I still wanted to question him and see where he was at. What kind of answer he gave to me. He said, "Man, not after what they did to us. They're not going to be killing us all over the planet and then walking around with our women without me saying something to their ass." I said, "Man, you smooth served his ass, though. What are you afraid of? You might get in trouble. He's a big white guy. I mean, what's the deal? You just didn't care." He said, "Man, I ain't going to tell y'all what he said he'd do. But he was just crazy as hell." I mean, this dude was crazy, yo. So we started talking, and I ended up going to his house with him. We went over there and we was medicating over there, and he put this guy on his TV. He said, "So you a Christian?" I said, "No, I ain't no Christian, but I go to congregate with black people." I said, "I know that Jesus is black. He wasn't no white man." He was like, "Man, his name wasn't Jesus. His name was Yeshua." Then he started talking to me, and me and him started kicking it. And then he said, "Man, let me show you something." He put this guy on. I sat down, watched this guy all day, 4 hours. He had so many Ashwa Kwesi. He had everything. Jewel Pukum, Marimba Ani, Ashwa Kwesi, he had freaking Hagens, my man, the big guy, what is his name? Damn, why can't I think of his name? He had Bobby Hemmett and Phil Valentine and another guy, the Hagens, I can't think of his first name. But anyway, out of all of them, I was really impressed. And I just started listening to Ashwa, and from there I started searching up in Egypt. I had already been getting inclinations about Egypt, you know what I mean? And so, yeah, after that I just was really, I was just intrigued to go after everything I could find out about Kemet, ancient Kemet, which we know as Egypt. So I'm going to go ahead and share this with you guys and let me know what you think.
Of Amen, Ipet Asut, or Ipet Asut, and other temples where the priests also baptized the initiates once they finished 40 years. This is long before John the Baptist. Now, this temple called Karnak today, or Ipet Asut, as our ancestors called it, going into this temple, as I said, these are temples of books and stone. The pylons are pages of history telling of our story. But as you go into the temple, you see the ram symbolized as Amun. That was the Zoop type as Amun. Now, we see Ursa Ma'at Ra, Septemen Ra, Ramesu, Rari Amun, a little practice you can say it too.